Good day, I am Kimberly and Sataraine. Let us now move on to chapter 6.4 entitled Based on the Evidence, Assess Risk and the Types of Risk. Now before risk can be assessed, the auditor must perform risk assessment procedures. These are audit procedures designed to obtain an understanding of accounting and internal control systems, assist in examining the risk of material misstatement at the financial statement level and assertion level for classes of transaction, account balances, and disclosures, and to develop an audit strategy and audit plan. Take note of the two levels of risk of material misstatements, which are the financial statement level and the assertion level. When we say the risk of material misstatement at a financial statement level, these are certain risks that could affect financial statements as a whole and potentially have a major impact on several assertions. For example, this may include managerial incompetence, poor oversight by the board of directors, and even inadequate accounting system and records. Whereas, the risk of material misstatement on an assertion level is composed of an assessment of inherent risk and control risk, which will be further discussed later on. Now, to assess the misstatement risk, the auditor performs four tasks. First, identify risk by developing an understanding of the entity and its environment, including relevant controls that relate to the risk. Analyze the strategic risk and the significant classes of transactions. Second, relate the identified risk to what could go wrong in the management's assertions about completeness, existence, valuation, occurrence, and measurement of transactions or assertions about rights, obligations, presentations, and disclosure. Third, determine whether the risks are of magnitude that could result in a material misstatement of the financial statements. And last, consider the likelihood that the risk will result in a material misstatement of the financial statements and their impact on classes of transactions, account balances, and disclosures. Let us now move on to the business risk, audit risk, and its components. To start off with the business risk, these are risks that result from significant conditions, events, circumstances, or actions that could adversely affect the entity's ability to achieve its objectives and execute its strategies. Take note that not every business risk will translate directly in a risk of a material misstatement in the financial statements, which is often referred to as audit risk. Now, audit risks are risks that the auditor gives an inappropriate audit opinion when the financial statements are materially misstated. It is a measure of how reliable the information used by the accounting system is, such as how much reliance can be put on it. Take note that the higher the audit risk, the more evidence must be gathered in order for the auditor to obtain sufficient assurance as a basis for expressing an opinion on the financial statements. There are three components of audit risk. These are inherent risk, control risk, and the detection risk. Inherent risks are errors or omissions that are likely to occur in the client's financial statements from factors that are not a failure of control. Inherent risk is usually higher when there is a higher degree of judgment and estimation involved, or when the company's transactions are very complex. Control risks, on the other hand, are errors that bypass controls. Control risks tend to be higher when the internal controls are not adequate to prevent and detect fraud or error. Lastly, detection risks are risks that an auditor's substantive procedures will not detect a misstatement that exists. Take note that there is an inverse relationship between the detection risk and the combined level of inherent and control risk. For example, when the inherent and control risks are high, acceptable levels of detection risk needs to be low to reduce the audit risk to an acceptably low level. On the other hand, when the inherent and control risks are low, an auditor can accept a higher detection risk and still reduce the audit risk to an acceptably low level. Moving on to the significant risk. These are audit risks that require special audit consideration. Significant risks generally relate to judgmental matters and significant non-routine transactions, wherein the risk of material misstatements may be greater than for ordinary transactions. So a more in-depth understanding helps the auditor develop an effective audit approach. In a special audit consideration, the auditor evaluates the design of the entity's controls, including the relevant control procedures, and obtains contemporaneous evidence as to whether or not they have been implemented. Further, it is required that the auditor perform substantive procedures that are specifically responsive to the risk. Now, when can you tell if a risk is significant? The determination of risk is a matter for the auditor's professional judgment, wherein they consider matters including whether the risk is a risk of fraud, the likelihood of the occurrence of the risk, the likely magnitude of the potential misstatement and the possibility that the risk may give rise to multiple misstatements, whether the risk is related to recent significant economic, accounting, or other developments, and therefore requires specific attention. The complexity of transactions that may give rise to the risk, whether the risk involves significant transactions with related parties, the degree of subjectivity in the measurement of financial information related to the risk, and whether the risk involves significant transactions that are outside the normal course of business for the entity, or that otherwise appear to be unusual given the auditor's understanding of the entity and its environment.